It's been a whole year now since AI has taken humanity by storm.
Artificial intelligence could replace millions of jobs.
Technical and societal impacts of the latest generation of AI chips.
That will all be done in the next couple of decades. Better, cheaper, faster by AI.
With some rampant development running through in all spaces because of the introduction of AI. Whatever space you're in, creative, tech, ops, learn it or make way. To keep up with this very fast spinning planet that's evolving so rapidly. As artists and creators, there are a bunch of tools available to us that we can totally benefit from picking up. Now, while the usage of AI raises a lot of questions, especially in the creative space, you know, training your AI data sets and models using the artwork of some incredible artists without their permission. And while ethically there are a bunch of such concerns, its wild power cannot be ignored. I mean, I don't know what the future holds and what this tech is eventually going to evolve into. It may just get to a space where eventually, ethically, everything's appropriate and okay. Irrespective of how it is today, I sure as shit don't want to lose out on an opportunity to learn a new tool, especially if this is what is going to be the way of the future.
The way of the future. The way of the future. The way of the future.
One such tool is, of course, Stable Diffusion, a super powerful open source image generator that's available for free. Hello and welcome to Breakdowns. And in this episode, we'll see a thing or two about comfy UI, an interface that we could leverage to use Stable Diffusion. Right from the installation process to how to use it, we'll see it all. Right, so before we jump right into the hustle, little bit of context setting. As a creator, especially if you're a part of a team of 2-3 people or even one person, you have to embrace tools like this to keep up with the world. In fact, even in corporates, the name of the game today is optimization and profit and whatnot, and everybody is constantly moving towards strategies and workflows which enable productivity and movement towards much faster output. Undoubtedly, the incorporation of AI is one such strategy that's being adopted everywhere, especially in the creative and coding spaces. Thought I'd show you really quickly a little bit of a tiny creation that I made using just ChatGPT and Stable Diffusion. So this was an experiment where I was working on a full-length feature book for children with some artwork and, of course, a storyline. And since it was an experiment at the end of the day, what I was trying to do was take very famous scary horror movies and make a rendition that works really well for children. So this is an example of, I guess, when Dr. Hannibal boinks Miss Red Riding Hood, I don't know. But a really quick look-see into how you could leverage AI in content creation in general, right? And why Gemini, ChatGPT, Midjourney, Stable Diffusion, these all are your new best friends. So why go through the pain of installing Stable Diffusion when you already have the likes of Midjourney and DALL-E available? Mainly because the usage of Stable Diffusion is completely free. It allows you to prompt and download infinite number of images that you can save onto your local system. In fact, a lot of the offerings and tools that are out there to a large extent leverage Stable Diffusion as their base. It allows you to do whatever the f*** you want, however the f*** you want to. So the previous best way to use Stable Diffusion used to be this interface called Automatic 1111. And honestly, I was actually working on showing a quick tutorial on how to install and use Automatic 1111. But the space of AI is moving so fast, by the time I could even get down to making the video, there was another interface already available, far more powerful, user-friendly that people started preferring. Which is why I thought, let's just jump straight into creating the tutorial for Comfy UI itself. So without messing about too much, let's get into the installation of Comfy UI, a node-based insane interface that allows you to do some really trippy shit. So really quickly, let's get into the process. I'm gonna start off by creating a new folder called AI Art Tool. And so now let's just get into terminal. We got to do a little bit of coding here to install a bunch of things. This, of course, is how you install it on a Mac. The process is pretty similar in Windows as well. I'll link a couple of videos that I found on YouTube that show you how exactly you could do it on a Windows system, right after which you can come back to this timestamp and see how to use Comfy UI. But anyway, onwards, with respect to Mac itself, a few commands that we should just know and what exactly they do. So PWD, for example, shows you where you are in the system at the moment. CD with the forward slash just takes you to the root of your system. If you type CD slash and drag the name of the folder, then it takes you into that particular folder, which is ideally where we want to be right now. Now we need to install Homebrew. So the process is very simple. As soon as you get onto their landing page, you can just take the link that they've given straight off and paste it in the terminal window. So Homebrew basically allows you to install other scripts and tools like Python and stuff of that sort, which we require. It's a package handler, so to say. And I may be wrong, I'm not a total techie, so do correct me in the comments if that is the case. But once you've managed to successfully install Homebrew, or more importantly, to check if it has been successfully installed, let's just type the command brewdoctor. And if you're lucky, it would tell you that your Homebrew is ready and good to go. It seems like I have a couple warnings to take care of. Seems like my command line tools are too outdated. So it's very clearly told me what I need to do if that is the case. So just in case you also come across a problem similar to this, then this is what needs to happen. So copy paste the first command that it has recommended to run, put in your password, and the second command. There we go, paste it there. And install. Okay, once the installation has been taken care of, next what we need to do is just confirm if everything is set with Homebrew, and seems like that is the case. Your system is ready to brew. Beautiful. Now let's look to install Python 3. Oops, that's a little bit of a mistake I've made with that command. There should be no space. So before I install Python, just want to check what version I already have on the system, for which the command is Python 3 space dash dash version, says it's 3.9.6. So to run Comfy UI successfully, you need to have Python 3.1.1 installed. So let's put in the command really quickly that enables us to do that. Brew install Python at 3.1.1. And there you go, the process of Python's installation has started. So once that's done, the next thing we need to do is install PyTorch. And I'll share the link with you in the description so that you know exactly where to go and get PyTorch. But it's fairly simple. Once you get there, you click on get started. We need the nightly version. You click on that, copy the command that it's shared to install it. Just keep an eye out here though. The command will come as pip3, but because we are doing this for Python 3.1.1, and just to make sure, especially if you have another Python version already installed in your system, best to put it as 3.1.1 before you install it. So there you go. And it gets installed. Now that PyTorch is installed, next what we need to do is clone the GitHub repository into our folder. So first let's make sure we are in our folder. I've already shown you how to do that with CD forward slash, and we don't really need to worry if you're thus far following exactly what I've been talking about, because we are already in that particular folder, AI Art Tool. And this is the command that we need to run. Git clone and from the particular URL, all of which has been already linked in the description box, so don't worry about it. And once that happens, it clones it into that particular folder like we just talked about. And if you can see in AI Art Tool, Comfy UI, and it's already here. Now there's a requirements.txt file which tells you all the stuff that we need so that we can successfully run Comfy UI. So let's see how we can install that. So here's the command that we need to run. Let's get into that folder first, the Comfy UI folder. And as you can see, we are there. And now we type in this command. Again, keep an eye out for the 3.11 so that you're in the correct version, and you install dash r requirements.txt. And there we go. Once the installation is completely taken care of, it will take a little bit of time. Now we are good to run Comfy UI. So as you can see, there's a main.py folder, which is what enables us to run it. Give it its time. The first time takes a little bit longer than the rest of it. And once that's done, you will end up getting a URL, which you can then use and open on your browser to run Comfy UI, as you can see here. And boom, after all that hustle, there we go. We've gotten Comfy UI set up on our system to do some AI magic. Okay, so before we get into the specifics of Comfy UI itself, thought I'll show you really quickly how you need to open Comfy UI if you've closed the window, or in the future, the next time or the next day. So as simple as the last code we ran, basically, we make sure that we have the correct folder with the cd forward slash and the folder drag command. And then we run python 3.11 space main.py. And again, you'll get the same URL, which you copy paste into your browser and then you run it. Okay. Now that we've gotten that out of the window, let's focus purely on how to use Comfy UI itself. So really quickly, the first node that you see here is where you load the checkpoints, and we'll get into that in a little bit more detail. This one here is where you put in the prompt, like how in Midjourney on the Discord server in the chats, you kind of type what exactly you want and then it gives you that. That's what this is. Here you can see the negative prompt, and below that is where you decide the size of the image and the number of images you wanted to generate. Then here is a sampler, basically. There are a bunch of things to keep an eye out for. The seed, which would be randomized, you leave as is for now. And the more you start playing around with it, you'll understand the importance of the seed itself and how you could use that number to make incremental change to a particular design. The number of steps, of course, is about how long the AI will take to process your command and how refined the final output would be. The CFG number decides how closely it'll follow the prompt. So 8 to 10 is fairly okay. The different samplers that you have will kind of affect how exactly that final image is rendered. We'll leave it in Euler for now. And then of course, save image with whatever name that you want, right? And once that's done, and once you've put in your prompt, all you have to do is click on Cue Prompt and you should get your image. Oops, there's a little bit of an error, and that's because I forgot to install the checkpoint model. So really quickly, how we do that is copy that particular checkpoint that was showing in that load checkpoint node, copy that into Google, and you'll get a link to Hugging Face, which basically is a site where you can download tools built with ML to make applications and stuff like that, right? So here is where you will get a lot of the models that can be used for Stable Diffusion and a bunch of other AI tools. And once that particular model has been installed, or that checkpoint has been installed, we need to copy it into that particular folder. Once that's done, and when you queue prompt, you will see it running successfully. And hey, there we go. Our image, based on the prompt that we gave, the conventional default prompt that's already there, it loads. And you could open the image, save the image into your local PC, howsoever you'd like. Right? So that's very quickly how you could use Stable Diffusion via Comfy UI. But like I mentioned at the very beginning, the possibilities are endless with respect to this interface, and the kind of stuff that you can actually do is nuts. And the only way you can actually do that is if you have a lot more nodes to work with. For that, we need to install Comfy UI Manager. Before we get into that though, if you found this video useful till now, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. That'll help others with their AI art journey as well. And if there are a couple places where you actually got stuck in the process of installing Comfy UI for Stable Diffusion, then do drop some comments so that we can help you out with the same. All right, so back to Comfy UI Manager. So to install Comfy UI Manager, first let's make sure we are in the correct folder, which is inside Comfy UI and inside Custom Nodes. So once we are in Custom Nodes, very similar to how we did the git clone command earlier and we installed a repository onto our folder. That's kind of what we do here with this command, again in the description box, so don't worry. Once that's done, you will see how Comfy UI Manager has been successfully installed. Now let's get into the right folder again and let's run python.311 space main.py and get into Comfy UI on our browser. There we go. Now you will see there's a manager tab that wasn't there earlier. On clicking it, we go into install custom nodes And really quickly, let's install the ControlNet node. ControlNet is a very powerful tool that literally allows you to upload an image of a model and then use the pose that that model was uploaded in to render your image in that particular pose. But enough talk, let me show you how it's done. But before that, first let's install it. So we look for ControlNet over here and search. There are a bunch of such custom nodes. So this is the one that we're looking for. ControlNet auxiliary preprocessors. And we click on install. And as you can see, it's installing. Give it a little bit of time. And once it's done, click on restart. And there you go. Now, once you have installed that particular custom node, the next thing you need to do is install the models by which you could use the custom node, right? So again, ControlNet. And let's see what OpenPose model we could potentially use. This one, V2, let's install this. And this will take its own sweet time, so don't worry too much if it takes half an hour, 40 minutes. But once that's done, you will be able to see the magic that I'm talking about. Now that it's installed, we start adding the nodes and just making sure that we are able to feed ControlNet into our entire system so that eventually what I talked about earlier, using the pose of one model to make an impact on your final output in the other, works out. So we add node, we go to image, we load an image, and here's your first node. Space it out a little bit. Now add another node, ControlNet preprocessors, faces and pose extender, open pose, and we connect them. Right? Now we add another node to preview the image and we connect that. So let's just download an image of a model real quick. Say somebody writing. Let's just see how this works out, right? Let me just download it off lexica.art. It could be your own photo. It could be anything off the net. That doesn't really matter. And let's replace the image that we have, the T pose, with our model. And then when you click on cube prompt, what you'll notice is, see, it's kind of running that particular prompt at the moment. As soon as it's done, what you'll see is ControlNet's magic. All the different limbs are very clearly identified in a very simple ball and stick model that we will now leverage for our particular prompt. So what's gonna happen is, what prompt we put right now is gonna end up in that particular pose because of ControlNet. So what we want is a lady in a red dress, say with a mountain background, colorful, cosmic purple. I don't know what she's gonna be doing writing over there, but let's see how we can make that happen. Right, so now what we do is we search real quick, ControlNet, apply ControlNet, and we connect our prompt to that particular node. And then we connect that node to the sampler itself so that our prompt is run through the apply ControlNet node. Right, now we connect our open pose node to it, and let's add another one, load ControlNet model, and connect that as well. And I know this could get a little overwhelming, but if you've just followed this to the T, the way I've mentioned and talked about, you would be very easily able to execute the same. And once that's done, finally you get this image. So yeah, that was a super quick tutorial on how you could install Comfy UI, a little bit of the interface itself, and how you could install a set of models and custom nodes that you could leverage to make whatever art that you actually want to. If you like that and you want us to make more such videos about how we could leverage AI tools in our day-to-day jobs, especially in the creative space, then do let me know in the comment section below. And if this helped with your hustle, then please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. It'll help us with our efforts and also give us a hint or two that this is the kind of content that you like. Peace out. I'll see you in the next one.